Good morning, my dear friends. Sino, in the last class, we were seeing the check for shear, and we came to know that shear reinforcements in the form of stirrups are also now required. So now, also we have seen that we have taken a decision to go for 8 mm 5 stirrups like this. The stirrup will come like this, 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 hook it like this. Okay, so it is now two-legged vertical stirrups on this. Okay, since it is two-legged vertical stirrups, ASV we have calculated. ASV is pi by 4 into 8 square. It will give you area of one cross-sectional leg here now. And since it has got two legs, it is into 2. Am I right now? So ASV also we have calculated. So now, let us see now what AS4 says. How to calculate the spacing of these vertical stirrups now? Spacing, in sense, at what distance I would keep the stirrups in the beam? Suppose now this beam is now coming out of the platform. Okay, the beam is coming out of the platform. Okay, so now stirrups at what distance I have to want him? Spacing I want to calculate. Center to center, spacing of these stirrups I want to now calculate. So now, your IS code gives you one simple equation by which I can calculate the spacing of the vertical stirrups. SV it is called, spacing SV. So it is there on page number 73. The equation is 0.875 ASV divided by PUS. Okay, so 0.87 is 0.87. You need not remember this equation. It is there in the IS code. Okay, no need to remember this equation. Okay. 0.87 is now here. Fy is yield stress of the steel. ASV, just in the last class we have calculated this ASV. It is the area of two-legged vertical stirrups. Okay, it is 100.83. D, effective depth, 370 mm. Fus is your design shear force. This also we have calculated in the last class. So it will give you a center-to-center distance of 3824 mm. This is one spacing. Okay? Again, your IS code interrupts you and it says that our spacing can also be calculated based on one more criteria called minimum shear reinforcement criteria. Okay? Minimum shear reinforcement criteria. In a sense, minimum shear reinforcement criteria means your IS code says that minimum this much shear reinforcements in the form of vertical stirrup should be there in the beam, whether the beam is safe or not. So according to that, okay, it says that according to this minimum shear reinforcement criteria, okay, the rule says that ASV by BSV should be greater than or equal to 0.4 divided by 0.875. This is what your IS code gives. Okay, it is there on page number 48. I will show you now. Okay, just a minute. See now, on page number 48, on page number 48, it is here now, 48 page, IS code. Come, go to the top here now. It says minimum shear reinforcements. Is it there now? Minimum shear reinforcement. I will read. Minimum shear reinforcements in the form of stirrups shall be provided such that ASV by BSV should be greater than or equal to 0.4 divided by 0.75. Whatever I have written on the board, the same equation is now there now. Am I right? So now, Papa, this equation is taken from your IS code and you need not remember. Okay, so from this equation, I want to calculate the spacing SV. Okay, I think you can cross multiply and you can write the equation for spacing SV easily. SV, if I cross multiply here, this here, it will become 0.87 Fy ASV divided by 0.4B. So now I will fill up all the values. 0.87 is 0.87, Fy is 415, ASV 100.53. 0.4 is 0.4 and breadth B is 300. Okay, so it will give you one more spacing as 347 mm center to center. This is my second spacing. This is my first spacing. This is my second spacing. Okay? I did not show you this situation, which is there on page number 73. I will show you in just a minute. On page number 73, you can see here. Page number 73 is here. The equation is not here. Vus is equal to, okay? Vus is equal to, this much is there now. Am I right now? The same equation. Okay? So from that, I'm calculating the spacing. What's that now? Okay. See now. Well, now, this is the second spacing I have obtained now. Am I right now? So now, one more thing you want to expose is, what it says is now, under any circumstances, the maximum spacing for the stirrups should not be greater than 0.75D or 300mm, whichever is less. Among these two, whichever is less, that I will take as maximum spacing. It is again there on page number 47. I will show you afterwards. Okay? So 0.75, D is effective depth is 370mm, so it will give me 277. Okay? Either this I will take or this I will take, among these two, whichever is less. Okay? Among these two, whichever is less, I will take. So among these two, less is this. So the maximum spacing is 277 centimeters. But this is my third spacing. Okay? So now I want one spacing, second spacing, and third spacing. But now, according to the IS code, out of all these three, 1, 2, 3, I will take the least of 1, 2, 3. Okay? Adopt spacing lesser of 1, 2, 3. So but I think out of these three, lesser is 277mm. Am I right? So now I am adopting 277mm. And since it's a very odd figure, I will say 270mm center to center. Okay? So instead of 277mm center to center, I am going to give 270mm center to center. And see now, another important thing is now, okay? See now, whenever I want to provide the stirrups, here I will give two anchor bars. Am I right now? Anchor bars I am going to provide here. These are your anchor bars. These are your two anchor bars. One anchor bar is here, another anchor bar is not here. So whichever bars are available on the site, you can take them. Now I have taken anchor bars as two bars of 10mm. Okay? So these two are the anchor bars. Anchor bars you are going to see them here on the top. Okay? So now you have to provide the stirrups here now like this. Okay? And these stirrups are, what's that called? These stirrups are at 270mm center to center. In the sense, from here to here, 270mm center to center. From here to here, 270mm center to center. Am I right? But now, since the shear force is less at the center, but I can increase the spacing so that I can achieve some economy. Okay? I will increase the spacing at the center here now. I am spacing maybe increased to 320mm center to center at mid-span. Because shear force at the center here is now zero, almost zero. So at the end here, I will keep spacing as 270mm center to center. And here now, spacing I will keep it as 320mm center to center. Okay? So now, that completes your design for shear. Okay? This is how now the beam looks like. Okay? Detailed drawing I will give you afterwards. Okay? Thank you very much. We'll stop it.